Hello, my name is Andrew Hodgson, and welcome to my YouTube channel, where in 10 minutes or less, we talk about life, faith, and what it means to be a follower of Jesus today. This is the second part of a two-part video series where I'm talking about millennials, why we're so awesome, and what I believe to be our generation's greatest strength. If you missed part one of this video series, I put the link to that video in the description below, and if you like this video, go on and smack that like button and consider subscribing. Before we jump into today's video, I want to let you all know about something else I'm doing on my YouTube channel homepage. For those of you who watched my video a few weeks ago, titled 31 Things I Learned by 31, you'll know that I'm passionate about worship. So I've created a new worship playlist feature on my YouTube channel homepage. And every month I will pick some of my favorite worship songs that are already up on YouTube, and I will compile them into a playlist for you guys to listen to. So whether you're spending time with God, commuting, walking your dog, working out, whatever it is you do, it's there for you to listen to. So if you're passionate about worship like me, or you're trying to find something new to listen to, go and check it out. So without further ado, let's jump into today's video. In last week's video, part one of why millennials are awesome, we talked about some statistics about millennials, and we saw that one of the marks of the millennial generation is our deep desire to change the world. And not just that, but our belief that we can. And we saw that that belief isn't actually narcissistic, but it's a good thing. And more than that, it's a biblical thing. We looked at the Lord's Prayer and the Great Commission, and we saw that those are about changing the world. And we also looked at 2 Corinthians 5, where Paul tells followers of Jesus that now we are ambassadors, and that that title, ambassadors, is about changing the world. So the belief that we can change the world isn't just some nice fluffy thing to believe, it's actually a mark of a follower of Jesus. So if last week's video was about the why we should be world changers, this week's video is about the how to be a world changer. If we believe that we're called to be world changers, that God really wants us to change the world, then how do we go about doing it, and what does it look like? Well, before we go any further, let me stop for a moment and clarify what I mean by making an impact or by being a world changer. I don't mean that we're gonna be elected the youngest prime minister or president of our country. I don't mean that we're gonna be put in charge of some major Fortune 500 company, or even that we're gonna have any particular powerful position at all. In fact, while we're in the business of busting myths, let's bust another one. You don't even have to go into full-time ministry to be a pastor or a missionary to change the world. Because here's the bottom line. Changing the world isn't about position, it's about a culture and a value system. Positions are great, and if you get put in one of those, please lead well from that place of influence, but that's not what it means to be a world changer. Changing the world can be done by anyone, anywhere. We see this all throughout the Bible, right? God uses tax collectors, fishermen, prostitutes, the wealthy, the poor, the demonized, and the sick to transform the world around them. The point? Position has nothing to do with it, and we need to get over that hurdle if we're going to make an impact and change the world. Because if we needed to have some special position or career in order to change the world, very few of us would ever do it. So position has nothing to do with it, but culture and value system has everything to do with it. In part one of Why Millennials Are Awesome, we looked at the Lord's Prayer, and inside that prayer is a clue, a hint, into what culture and value system we as followers of Jesus are supposed to be part of. In that prayer, it says this: your kingdom come and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So what culture and value system do we want to adopt, create, and build here on earth? Well, according to that prayer, we want to adopt, create, and build heaven's culture and heaven's value system. So whether you're a bank teller, a teacher, a stay-at-home mom, a CEO, a programmer, a truck driver, you have an opportunity and a place of influence to create and build heaven's culture and heaven's value system. In Matthew 6:33, Jesus says, "Seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and he will give you everything you need." The Passion Translation translates that first part like this. It says, "So above all, constantly chase after the realm of God's kingdom and the righteousness that proceeds from him." I believe with all my heart that when we start actively chasing God's kingdom realm and pursuing it, using opportunities as they come up, whether it be at home, at work, at school, at the grocery store, that we're going to see God's kingdom realm take root. And when it takes root, that's when the world begins to change. If we start actively sniffing out ways to bring heaven to earth and praying for it, we're going to see it. So what does it mean or look like to sniff it out, to chase after God's kingdom realm, and to see it transform the cultures and the value systems around us? Well, simply put, it looks like this. We inject hope into the hopeless. We mourn with those who are mourning. We take care of the widows and the orphan. We release healing to the sick. We bring freedom to those who are in chains, and we welcome the lost into the family of God. To break it down a little bit more practically, it looks like this. If you have a coworker who is struggling with a hopeless situation in their home life, take time to listen to them and pray for them. If you see someone at the grocery store who's wearing a sling for a sore shoulder, then ask them if you can pray for them to be healed. If you know someone someone in your neighborhood is struggling to put gas in their car, get them a $20 gas card. If a friend loses a loved one, come alongside them and mourn there with them. The point is this, keep your eyes open because there are lots of opportunities to see the kingdom of heaven break in. There are a few of us where I work who are praying for this very thing, to see God's kingdom realm invade our workplace. We're actively experimenting and sniffing out opportunities to see his kingdom invade our workplace and the lives of all the employees. A few months ago, we had a new employee join our company, a guy who had bounced around from job to job. And on his second or third day, somebody asked him how he was liking it. And his response was this. He said, "I really like it here. It feels like heaven." And a short while later, he gave his life to Jesus. The point is this, it's possible to see God's kingdom realm come and to transform our workplaces, our schools, our homes, and our cities. If it wasn't possible, then God would be a cruel taskmaster for asking us to do something that's impossible. But he's not that. He's good, and he wants to use us, his sons and daughters, to transform and to see his kingdom realm come to earth. He definitely doesn't need us to do it, but he wants to use us. So my fellow millennials, you were born to change the world, but it doesn't matter what your job or your career is. It doesn't matter what your social standing is. It doesn't matter if you're married or not married. It doesn't even matter how much money is in your bank account. Psalm 18:35 says this, "You have given me your shield of victory. Your right hand supports me, and your help has made me great." On the cross, Jesus not only set us free and made a way for us to become children of God, but he qualified us to take part in establishing his kingdom here on earth. So millennials, go and change the world. Find new ways and opportunities to see God's kingdom realm invade every space and place that you go. Let us be the generation who don't just believe that we can change the world, but who are actively engaged in pursuing it. Hey, thank you so much for watching this video. If you're looking for another resource on this topic, I highly recommend Bill Johnson's book, When Heaven Invades Earth. He goes into this topic in much greater detail, and he has some great stories of people who are seeing heaven invade earth all around them. And as always, if you like this video, then go ahead and smack that like button. And I'd love to hear what you guys think about this stuff in the comments below, especially if you guys have stories of seeing this stuff happen around you. And if this is the kind of content you like and you want to see more of it, go ahead and hit that big red subscribe button and the tiny little bell next to it so you stay notified every time there's a new video. See ya!